Hello everyone, and welcome to another edition of New Tech Tuesday Tutorials. I am your host, Richard Evans, and every now and then when I'm brainstorming ideas with what topics to cover for the series, I'll think to myself, well, what do I not know how to do on this TriCaster? I mean, there's tons of features on it, and then I stumbled across something that was sitting right in front of me the whole time, and I just didn't pay it any mind. And the more I started to ask about it, the more mysterious it became. And it's something that has now been dubbed the icon. And I must apologize for that terrible dad joke, but it doesn't have a name, that's what we're all calling it, but it does something pretty cool. So let's check it out. All right, so here we are in the TriCaster TC1 interface, and what I want to bring your attention to is right over here. It's gonna be right between the background delegate and fade to black button. It's this little eyeball icon, which I have just been kind of sitting there this whole time and didn't know what it did, and now I finally do, and I'm passing that knowledge on to you. Okay, so let me go ahead and bring on a few different pieces of media here on screen. So I'm gonna slide my downstream keyer number one on screen here. All right, and then I'm also gonna bring on my downstream keyer number two, like that. All right, so I have my little lower third here and my live bug here in the top right. So now if I go through and switch my show, let's say I wanna transition over to my preview row over here. So the way I would do that, I would either use a T-bar on my control surface or one of these auto buttons here and do that. And I have now done a transition over to that shot. But keep in mind, take a look. He has the lower third there of my name and that live icon above it. So no matter how I switch my show, if I'm just punching up inputs live straight on the program row, etc., those downstream keyers are going to stay active because I have brought them on screen and have not taken them off. Okay, so let's go ahead and fix that. And that's what this button will do. So what ends up happening now is when we click on this eye icon, it selects anything that's visible on your downstream keyers that are currently active on screen. So check this out. I will click on this eyeball icon. And now you'll see that my background, downstream keyer number one, and downstream keyer number two, delegate, have all been selected. So now whenever I do that transition over to my other shot by clicking the auto button here, it's gonna take everything that's visible on screen off. So go ahead and do that, boom. And the transitions that I had assigned to those downstream keyers are gonna come with it. So since everything is still delegated, bring it back on screen, good to go. So it's a really nice way of being able to select whatever you have visible and then just group it together, and you can take it off screen using your auto transitions. So the icon is pretty dang convenient, to be honest, and it's little things like this that help me out whenever I'm creating my own shows, and I really hope that they're helping you out as well. Now for more videos like this one, subscribe to our YouTube page at youtube.com/newtechinc. For more information on New Tech products, talk to your local reseller or visit our site at newtech.com. Also, check out newtech.tv where you can stay up to date with the latest product information, interviews, testimonials, and more. You can also sign up for a free New Tech product demo by going to newtech.com/demo. So thank you all so much for watching, and we'll see you next time on the next edition of New Tech Tuesday Tutorials.